to say life is like a highway. Like, you really can't make U-turns. Like, you just have to learn how to move forward. And similar with being an entrepreneur, you have to learn how to move forward. So today I want to share a few things with you about how to make sure as an entrepreneur you're able to move forward, yeah? So what I want to introduce you to is a system called neuro-linguistic programming. And we say that NLP, in short, is just understanding the language of your mind, yeah? So that's how we can summarize it in a really short way. Very early on, even in your own surroundings, I'm sure you already have one or two people that you look at and say, gosh, she's actually in the same environment as me or in the same field as me, and I'm seeing that she's doing well, and I wonder if I can look at what models that she's using and actually use some of that, right? And that's why it's really important to have this model. So I want to take you through just some really key points. So we start here, yeah? So did you know that every day, yeah, you actually are bombarded by like 2 million bits of information per second, yeah? That's a fact. So every second now that I've been talking, you can imagine I've been talking now 5 minutes, like 2 million bits of information. So in order for your mind to be able to not go crazy, it has to learn how to filter that, yeah? And there's only three things I want you to remember. So the mind can only delete, distort, or generalize, yeah, information. That's the only three things it's able to do. So deletion is quite obvious, yeah? So even you've just given me that example. You literally just saw that and you're like, okay, everything else your mind unconsciously deleted. And that's very important even in how you run your businesses, what you see, how you do, and everything like that. So the other day even, I was in a business meeting, and the next day somebody comes to me and says, why didn't you send this email? You know, it was really important. And I was like, but you didn't tell me. And you know, they could have sworn they had told me to send this email, and it turned into a huge fight. And it took a bit of a moment for me to recognize and say, okay, my mind deleted that information. It wasn't important to me right in that moment, but fair enough, yeah? But that's what my mind does. Your mind does that, yeah? It has to basically survive. So distortion. Now, I think you can all give an example of distortion, yeah? And that's where Isaac was giving an example. Maybe a guy comes up to you and gives you a compliment, and you read it as a complete insult. Who has, okay, any woman who has experienced that, say I. And he's like, what? I just gave you a compliment. And you're like, no. That is not a compliment. That's an insult. Yeah, exactly. You know? So we are able to distort and interpret information very differently. Yeah? And that's a key thing in understanding ourselves. And finally, generalize. Now, this one is very dangerous, but also can be very effective in learning. Yeah? Because we can say all men are the same. Yeah, how many of us will say that all women are the same? There's a lot of healing work we need to do here. You know, so that can actually be very detrimental. And that's only based on 2 to 3 experiences of maybe a man and you're saying all men are trash, you know?
Yeah.
In the grand scheme of things, that is very detrimental, yeah? To your love relationships or etc. But on the good side is now, it helps us learn information. So every time I go to a door, yeah, I look at the door, I'm like, I know that's a handle, I know it opens, I know when I open it, it will move forward, and then I know how to close it. If my brain wasn't able to generalize, every time I go to a door, I would not remember or be able to say all doors open like this, all handles are like that, yeah? So that's why it's really important for us to also be able to generalize.